Students, welcome to my next video. Now we are going to do module 3, that is partial differential equations. In the previous module we have done ordinary differential equations, where we are involved with only the a function whose independent and dependent variables are there, and the partial derivatives of the given function with respect to the independent derivative independent variable. So we have it as a ODE, that is ordinary differential equation. Now here we are going to see what is a partial differential equation. You guys have studied what is partial differentials, that is partial differentiation, the process, in your previous semester. So here the differential equations involving with the partial derivatives is said to be a partial differential equations. Okay, we can consider, let us consider a function of two variables, z be a function of two variables f of x comma y. Then the partial derivatives of z with respect to x and y are dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y. These are the first derivatives, and if you consider the second, dou square z by dou x square, dou square z by dou y square, and also dou square z by dou x dou y, or dou square z by dou y dou x. These two are also the second order derivatives, the partial derivatives. Basically, you guys got to remember this. Anyways, so any equation which involves a function of two variables, two or minimum three variables, and the partial derivatives with respect to these two are independent variables. Anyways, okay. So partial derivatives with respect to at least one of these independent variable is said to be a partial differential equation. For example, we can have something like this: dou u by dou x plus dou u by dou y is equals to something, a constant, a simple partial differential equation. Differential equation. It is involved with both two partial derivatives of first order. Okay. So, and also we can have higher order partial derivatives, dou square z by dou x square minus some constant lambda dou z by dou x plus z is equals to 0. This involves with respect to only one variable. Okay. Anyways, so let's see ahead. Move on. Dou square z by dou x dou y with respect to both the variables. Okay, so is equals to x y. This is also one of the partial differential equation that you can consider. Understood, guys? Okay, so this is how we can frame a partial differential equation. These are the differential equations which we are going to deal in this module. Alright, so let us see what is the degree and order. First is order of the PDE. The short form of this is said to be PDE, the partial differential equation. So order of the PDE. As you know, how do we take the order of a differential equation, ordinary differential equation? This is the same way that we consider it for the partial differential equation as well. So the highest order derivative involved in that particular equation gives you the order of the PDE. If you observe the first equation, here the order of each and every term, we have only the first order derivatives. So the order in this case is 1. Okay. Anyways, in the second equation, we have both the second order and the first order partial derivatives. But however, whichever is the highest term, that has to be considered as the order for the entire equation. So for this particular equation, order is 2, and of course here also the order is 2. Like that we can consider the order. Anyways, what is degree? Degree of the equation is given by the degree of the highest order derivative. Both are of whole power 1, so it's degree 1. Here also it's degree 1. All these equations are having degree 1. You can ask me how does a partial differential equation with a degree 2 look like, where you have whole square, something like this. Then this becomes a second degree PDE. Second degree PDE whose order is like that. We can consider the order and degree of the differential equation. Got it? Partial differential equation specifically. Now we'll go ahead and see how do we form a PDE. We have two methods to form a PDE, formulation of a PDE. Let's see that in the next concept. Formulation of a PDE. As I told you, we have two types to form our formulated PDE. First one, by elimination of arbitrary constants. And second method is by the method of elimination of arbitrary functions. Okay, so depending on the given equation, either we got to eliminate the constant or we got to eliminate the function. If an arbitrary function is given, then we eliminate it. But if an arbitrary constant is given in the given equation, then we eliminate the constant and hence we can frame a PDE. Let us see both the methods, both the types of differential equations. What the types to form a PDE? So first is by the method of elimination of arbitrary constants. So formulation of a PDE by elimination of arbitrary constants. Okay, so the question will be like the same thing. So the question says form a PDE by eliminating the arbitrary constants. Understood, guys? Anyways, so let us see how do we solve this particular problem. So we have A and B, two partial, let it be squares, two arbitrary constants that we got to eliminate them by applying the partial differentiation on both sides. Okay, so let us partially differentiate with respect to x and y. Okay, both. Let's see. So what is that? So first, with respect to x, what will that become? That is supposed to be assumed as a function of x and y here. Whenever z is given, if u is given, then also it's the same. So this becomes zx. Otherwise, we can write 2 as it is, dou z by dou x. With respect to x, we are differentiating. Is equal to. Now, with respect to x, treating y as constant. That is the nature of the logic of partial differentiation, by treating, if we are differentiating with respect to x, we need to treat the second variable constant, and in this case, y is the second variable. And z is a function of both x and y, so you should not treat it as constant at any point of time. Okay, anyways, coming to this, 1 by a square as it is, derivative of x square is 2x plus y is supposed to be treated as a constant, the entire term. Otherwise, you can write 1 by b square into derivative of y square is going to be 0. Okay, so what do we get in this case, therefore? We have applied the standard terms. So 2p therefore is equal to, this will be completely 0, 2 by a square into x. Okay, so what is a square? Rearrange this equation and find what is a square. A square is equal to 2x by 2p, that is equal to x by 2, 2 gets cut. Okay, similarly, differentiate this equation now with respect to y. So what do we get when we differentiate with respect to y? We are supposed to treat the variable x as constant. Okay, so 2 into z with respect to y become dou z by dou y is equal to, this is supposed to be treated as constant. So 1 by a square into derivative of constant is going to be 0 because this is term of x alone. And if you have x and y, then you can take out x and then apply y. We'll see such a problem later. Anyways, coming to this, y square, 1 by b square as it is, y square derivative is 2y. Simplifying on both sides, we get, and apply the standard form, this is q. So 2q is equal to 2 by b square into y. That implies b square is equal to 2y by 2q, that is y by q. Now, substitute a square and b square values in this equation. So, what do you get there? Substituting a square and b square, we get 2z therefore is equal to x square, is as it is, my denominator a square is replaced by x by b, plus y square is as it is and my denominator b square is replaced by y by q, which is equals to, here x and x actually gets cut. If you are getting confused, you can do it in the next step, because denominator in the denominator goes to the numerator. This becomes x square p by x plus, here also q goes up, y square q by y. Now you can cut one term and you will be left out therefore with 2z is equal to px plus qy, and we no more have any constants here. Hence, this particular term or this particular equation can be treated as partial differential equation. Why? Because it is involved with the partial derivatives, dou x by dou z, dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y. Understood? So, this is how we can frame a PDE using by eliminating the arbitrary constants.